champ is here.
All right, this is my shit right here.
The champ is here.
This shit is crazy.
The evil genius Green Lantern.
The champ is here. The champ is here. The champ is here.
Yeah. Deep lock.
The champ is here. The champ is here.
Fucking with the champion.
You already know. KAD is the game. The body.
You ain't fucking with the champion.
You already know.
Green Lantern.
Tough kiss. Niggas know the champ isn't here. He took it from crack to rap. Now he put out 2 anthems a year. And I just wanna rock for a century and then chase the book with the documentary. If you can't do nothing other than flow, life's a bitch like the mother from Blow. Let's go, don't make me put your heart in your lap. Fuck riding the beat, nigga. I parallel park on the track. Hop out looking crispy, fresh and new. And it's 6, but it's a BM and it's Pepsi Blue. And I don't know you, but I know a man becomes a man from all the shit that he go through. And y'all ain't fucking with Jason. After I cash in, it's really no justification of how I'm gonna change the game. So don't get out of line, it's this little 9 to change your frame.
The champ is here.
Uh-huh.
The champ is here.
Kiss.
What's up, people? Patrick Royce here. How you guys doing? I know it's been a minute. I don't have any type of written or prepared statement or thing I'm going to bring. I'm just going to just take some of this off the top of my head. I apologize in advance if there's any cursing. I know there's a lot of cursing in some of my other videos, but it's just a lot of the stuff's just got me aggravated and so mad that sometimes it's just the best way for me to express myself to you guys so you can see just how upset I am about these things. We got a lot of Democratic supporters out there that are being blinded, fooled by the media over these Democrats out here that they're doing such great things. Let me just break something down for you guys so you can see just what you're dealing with out here with real life facts. Pelosi, Schumer, these people have been in this position that they're in since before Reagan. Before Ronald Reagan, they've been doing the same thing that they're doing now, which is fighting the president tooth and nail on absolutely everything. You guys weren't hired to go against the United States. You understand? You wasn't hired to look out for illegal immigrants from other countries. You understand that, don't you? Now, you think Democrats are looking out for you? Let's just take Pelosi's district. You see what her district looked like? How she takes care of the place that she's supposed to be in charge of? Or Cummings, how he took care of Baltimore? These guys over here trying to tell our president how to run stuff, how to do stuff, fighting him tooth and nail and everything. And their districts are complete shitholes. Their districts are just completely run down, but they're living the high life. Figure that out. These Democrats vote me in office. I'm looking out for you. I'm going to clean up these streets. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. You vote them in office, and what do? Absolutely nothing except take the money that they're giving to take care of you, and they're putting it in their own pocket, and then just side mouthing everybody, talking off the side of their mouth here, talking off the side of their mouth there. Look at Pritzker. I know I bring him up a lot, but just an example of this stuff. You have, just so you're aware of this, you got people in Congress, you got AOC, whatever they want to call her. To me, she's a fucking putz. All these fucking, you got a couple Muslims in there. Obama put those in there. You just think about that. And for those of you that aren't aware of that, Obama put them in there. Obama brought them over from Somalia. Oh, you can bring all your little refugees over here. So the girl that married her brother, Obama brought her here, placed her in the situation she's in so the people that he brought over here with her, other Somalians, can vote her in to Congress. Think about that. And some of the other ones that he brought in, he took them and put them in Arizona, where some of them have already been arrested for terrorism. He damaged our country severely from the inside out. You guys think he's such a great president? Oh, he did such great things. Because he's black, he's a great president? Because that's what I get a lot from a lot of you people. I don't care what his policies are. I don't care, blah, blah, blah. He's our first black president. You're fucking stupid. You're stupid as fucking stupid can be. If you're going to vote for somebody just because of the color of their skin, you're fucking stupid. And if you're going to believe somebody on just the lies they tell you just right up front without looking into shit, you're stupid. All right? He fucked you guys, and he fucked you guys bad. He went into the White House with, you know, a few $100,000, maybe whatever. He comes out of the White House a multi-millionaire selling plutonium to Russia. Is it worse that Trump went to talk to people in Russia or his people did because Russia said, hey, we have some dirt on Hillary? So somebody's going to talk to them, and apparently that conversation never even happened. But we got a couple years of investigation and over several million dollars put into this investigation over him supposedly making an appointment to talk to somebody about dirt on Hillary. You think maybe that dirt was Hillary and Obama selling them plutonium? But there's no investigation into that. I guess people don't want to be Epstein, right? Because I guess that's what happens with the Clintons. They will Epstein your ass, and they will just cover their tracks completely. How can the federal prison just let somebody just commit suicide? It's bullshit. You cannot, and just anybody, you want to test this theory out? Anybody test it out, and if you choke yourself out, it's just because you're stupid. Get a ladder that goes up to about here on you, all right? Now, when that ladder, or whatever you got right there, that's about this high to you standing up, tie your rope around that thing, and then tie it around your neck, and then try to hang yourself. What are you going to do? You're going to pull your feet up and hold them under you until you choke yourself out? No, because your body is going to struggle to survive. So the first thing that's going to happen is your feet are going to go back on the ground, which you're already able to stand on. He was murdered, guys. Come on, don't be fucking stupid. He was murdered. The one day out of all days that no guards check on him for a set period of time, that's because they said, if you don't see nothing, you can't say nothing. So just give us this window here of whatever hours. That's when our guy will get in there, take care of whatever he's got to take care of, and get out. Come on, Epstein had several broken bones in his neck. There's no way he could do that on his own by being able to stand up and hang himself while he's able to stand up. What'd he do? Jump in the air as high as he can with a rope around his neck and then hold his feet up and come down and drop? Come on, guys. Think, be a little smarter. So you got these congressmen, these Democrat congressmen in Washington right now that have their aides and some of their other personal staff on the other side of the border feeding these illegal immigrants, taking care of them over there, and telling them what to tell border agents and people to get on the other side over here. They're actually over there telling them what to tell us to get here. Telling them, bring your kids, and if you're lucky, you can give birth right when you get on the other side here. You're set. Democrats are doing that shit. And here's why. Because they're still getting their money from them when they put these bullshit taxes on cigarettes, these bullshit taxes on gas, the taxes they put on food, milk, soda pop tax, all that bullcrap. That's going in Democrats' pockets. Okay? So they don't care that you're illegal. They still want that money that you're able to put into stuff because you're buying things. Even though they're not paying taxes on anything, and that's coming out of our money. That's coming out of Americans' money to pay for all these little services and translations and all the paperwork. All that stuff that goes to these illegals, that comes out of our fucking pocket, guys. Out of Americans' pockets. And Democrats are the ones taking it out of our pockets and giving it to these people who never fucking had a foot in this fucking life to begin with. They come over here into our country and Democrats are just giving them everything. I'm not qualified for health insurance, but you're going to take my money and other Americans' money and you're going to say, come on over here, illegals. We're going to give you a free education and we're going to give you free health care. Fuck these people. We're taking the money to pay for you. Don't even worry about it. This is what you guys are voting into office. How stupid are you to vote that kind of crap into office? You got people running their fucking countries to the ground. You got people in their fucking cities destroying their cities. Look at Baltimore. You think that's just an isolated incident, an isolated place? No. Look at Pelosi's. Look at Schumer's. Look at all of these people running these freaking towns that are in the dirt, that are just ran to the fucking ground. Look who's running them. The same people trying to run our country right now and stop our president and everything he's trying to do. You want to say, oh, Trump's racist, Trump's racist. Believe whatever the fuck CNN's telling you, all right? Trump's been around for years. Check out 1988 when he had an interview with Oprah Winfrey and the Oprah Winfrey Show. Check out what he was saying then about running for president. He's saying the exact same thing he's saying now. And Oprah Winfrey was smiling while she's holding that mic talking to him because she liked what he was saying. But now, since Barack Obama's out of office, there's nobody black enough to be president. So obviously because Trump's white, he's racist. You guys are fucking stupid. Barack Obama is the one who built those facilities out by Texas that are holding those illegal immigrants that are coming over here by the hundreds of thousands. Every month, you get a minimum of hundreds of thousands every month. Hundreds of thousands times 12. What do you got? Millions. And they're taking over this country like a fucking invasion. And you guys are, oh, we're a sanctuary city. Not on my fucking watch. I ain't going to fucking accept that shit as sanctuary city. Whoever the fuck's talking about sanctuary cities, get them the fuck out of here. All right, fucking thieving, greedy fucking Democrats. Chicago, you got Lori Lightfoot. Little Lori Lightfoot talking about how she going to change things. She going to do this and do that. They're nothing but greedy motherfuckers. It's as simple as that. They want to put a bunch more casinos in Chicago. You can put more casinos, you're not going to get more gamblers. You're going to have the same amount of gamblers, but they're going to put these casinos up, and here's why. Because they have an outrageous bill that those casinos have to pay every year to stay open, which goes to Springfield, which is going right into that fat fucking Pritzker's pocket. Okay? You have her saying, well, the taxes are too high. We're not getting our cut out of this. And then you just had them sue the E-Juul company and the other electronic cigarette companies, and they got a little over $500,000. Now, why is Chicago suing E-Juul? Because of them supposedly making addictive nicotine stuff for kids or whatever. You're suing them supposedly on the behalf of the people. But you keep the money when you fucking sue them, don't you? That money goes right in your guys' pockets.
Incoming message.
Right? That money goes right in your pockets. So you're not suing them on behalf of us. You just look for every opportunity. You're like an ambulance chasing lawyer. That's all you are. You're an ambulance chaser. You just chase anything you can that you see anybody in. Oh, I can make money off of his situation. I can make money off of his situation. You guys are just greedy. You're fucking greedy. And now you got Pritzker talking right now about, he just made it law that illegal immigrants, undocumented people that aren't even supposed to fucking be here, are allowed to sue their landlords in court. And the landlords are not allowed to call ICE or government authorities on the illegals living in their house. He just made that law. Look it up. Dude, they're not here for us. Democrats are not here for us. They're here for whatever will make more money in their fucking pockets. Who the fuck are you to say I can't call the government, I can't call ICE to tell them I got illegals living in my house? Well, one, that would never fucking happen. All right? You're going to come here, you're going to have a fucking social security card because I'm going to do a background check on you right off the fucking bat. And if I find out there's two of you, I'm calling ICE on you myself. All right? I find out you're using somebody else's social security number, you're gone. So you made it law that illegal, undocumented people that aren't even supposed to fucking be here can now sue the people that do and are supposed to live here. And we aren't allowed to call ICE on them? Who the fuck are you, Pritzker, to say I can't call somebody and tell them about something illegal? Dude, that's illegal what you're doing. You're doing all kinds of illegal shit. You're aiding and abetting. All right, who the fuck are you? You're not a fucking American. You piece of shit. You're fucking from, I don't know where the fuck you're from. You're fucking from the toilet. All right? No wonder the fucking ketchup's bad nowadays. Your fucking fat ass fucking ate all the good shit. Man, it's like, you guys are so greedy. You're so fucking greedy. And you don't give a fuck about us. Who the fuck are you? Why are you people voting for him? Why are you people voting for any Democrat? Because name me one thing the Democrats have done for you. One thing. Can you name one thing that they've done for you? You can't, because they fucking haven't done a fucking thing. They haven't done a thing except talk shit, 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 and take your fucking money. That's all they do. There's no repairs. There's no fixes. There's no this. There's no that. They just take your fucking money, and your money's fucking gone. Period. Figure that shit out. What the fuck have you got from them? Not a fucking thing. They're fucking trying to make this place fucking Mexico. And there ain't a fucking thing none of you people are fucking doing about it. And that's fucking pathetic. You want to, well, CNN said this, or this news broadcast said this. Most of these news medias are owned by big Democratic supporters, okay? And here's what you guys might not know. Obama, in 2012, made it law that news medias can tell us propaganda, that they can purposely and deliberately lie right to our fucking face on the news, broadcast that shit to millions of people, and it be lies. He made that law in 2012. Look it up. That's why you're getting two different stories from different medias. That's why you got the fake news and the real fucking news, because the fake news is telling you whatever they want to tell us, and they legally can because Obama fucking made it law that they can. Think about that shit. He made it law that they can tell you whatever they want to fucking tell you because most of these fucking news medias are owned by Democrat supporters. So now they can tell us whatever they want to tell us, which is fucking propaganda all day long. That's what they do in fucking North Korea and all these other fucking countries where they're controlling the fucking people. Propaganda on the news to tell them whatever they want to fucking hear. Whatever we want you to know, we'll tell you. Don't worry about the facts. Don't like Sleepy Joe. Ah, truth beats facts every day. Well, truth over facts. Poor kids are just as smart as white kids. You're fucking stupid, Joe. You're fucking stupid. Sit your old fucking retarded ass down, you senile fuck. Sit the fuck down and retire like you're supposed to. You fucking Democrat fucks ain't helping us with shit. Oh, well, he gave us Obamacare. No, what he did is he got stock in health insurance, and he made it mandatory you had to fucking have it. That way, every fucking insurance company out there can now jack up their price, because now it's not a competition of we got the lowest price, so come to us. It's you have to fucking have it, so here it fucking is. And now you're getting it, and now every time you buy into that, that stock goes up. Obama's getting money in his fucking pocket. Duh. And then, oh, they're making weed legal. They're making weed legal. Yeah, because Pritzker's fat ass is putting a 35% tax on it. That's why he's making it legal. And because they have stock in this health insurance bullshit that's always paying out to people getting hurt at work and shit like that. Well, you're not going to be able to get paid out when you're getting hurt at work if you got marijuana in your system, are you? That's why he made it legal. So it's a double-fold pay on him. They get paid when you guys buy it, and they don't have to pay when you guys get hurt because that marijuana is legal, so you're smoking that marijuana. So when that shit's in your system, when you get fucked up at work, well, he had marijuana in his system. You guys ain't getting paid shit. All right? They just saved them a buck two ways from one. So don't think I'm against it. I mean, I got my bowl right here, man. I smoke, but it should be private. You should be allowed to buy it. You should be allowed to take it to your place. And as far as I'm concerned, after that shit, injuries at work, they should have that law that you get hurt and you have marijuana in your system, it doesn't affect your case. But they won't do that because then that's taking the money out of their pocket that they did all this planning to get in. You guys, man, you gotta start thinking more clearly. Don't just be taking everybody at their word when they're looking at you smiling. J.B. Pritzker's looking right at you smiling. Yeah, let's do a fair tax system. Hire me. Get me into law. Make me governor. Make me governor, and I'll make a fair tax system. No, you let him be governor, and he fucking reamed the fuck out of all of us. Yeah, a fair tax system... doubling the gas tax, doubling the registration fee, doubling the fee to get your license. You try to put a fucking dollar tax on ride shares. Every Lyft and every Uber ride, he's trying to get a dollar off of each one. Did you guys know that? No, I bet you didn't. They're fucking greedy, dude. They are greedy all day long. All right? Quit voting Democrats. We need to clear every fucking one of them out of office. Vote Republican. What the fuck you got to lose? The only thing I don't agree with the Republicans is their pro-life, pro-choice thing that they're doing with abortions and shit like that. I say every woman's body is her body to do what she feels is right with her body and her pregnancy. Well, it's wrong if she murders a baby. Well, that's her fucking business, and that's between her and God. That ain't between her and you and anybody else. Why don't you mind your fucking business, get your nose out of other people's business, and fucking figure out your own fucking life instead of worrying about everybody else's shit. Here's why we're at where we're at right now. All this protesting and shit going on all the time. One, Democrats are starting it. They have seeds that they have paid out there starting this shit to harass people, fucking get people going, get people agitated where they get out there and do these marches. Why don't you see marches supporting Trump? Why don't you see marches fighting all this other stuff? I'll tell you why. Because the people that would be in these marches are at fucking work. We're not sitting at home living with mommy and daddy. We're not working these coffee shop jobs, these little bullshit fucking jobs. We have all this time to be out doing shit. We actually got real jobs with paychecks that these piece of shit Democrats are taking as much as they fucking can out of. All right, I was just looking at my check the other day. Out of a circle like this, all right, just pretend that's a circle. That space right there, right here, that space, that's already what they're taking out of my check. What the fuck are you taking this for if I'm not seeing shit? Oh, we're investing in colleges. Oh, well, we're going to make the roads. Bullshit, you lying fuck. Bullshit. You're fucking putting that money in your fucking pocket. Because you're talking about giving fucking illegals, undocumented people, health insurance for free. Yeah, that's the best way to keep them from fucking bum rushing our fucking borders, right? Give them some free fucking health care. Give them some free fucking health insurance. Some public aid. Give them whatever the fuck they fucking need to keep them from bum rushing. You're fucking stupid. You guys say, oh, Trump's racist. No, the Democrats are racist against Americans. Think about that shit. They're only out for themselves 100% of the fucking time. Name one thing they've done for us. One thing. I'm fucking waiting. Because there is not a fucking thing they've done all these years. They're the ones who started the fucking KKK. Look at that shit. They want to call Trump racist and this and that. It's been proven by the Judicial Watch. Right now, look it up. It's been proven by the Judicial Watch, and they have the documents out there. The documents are online right now that shows and proves that the Obama administration, through the Department of Justice and his investigation services, was coinciding with the with the research campaign for Hillary Clinton's bullshit for her the Clinton Foundation. They was working together. It's proven. They was working together. There was a husband working on one. There's a wife working on the other. They came together, both unions, where the husband and wife are now working together, all right, from the two separate entities, to plant and make bullshit up about Trump, to make him look bad for the elections. Look it up, all right? You guys think Obama's all whistle clean? No, he's a dirty motherfucker. He's just got a better smile than some. That's what you need to fucking know. They fucking chewed us, they screwed us, and they're just trying to leave us in the fucking dirt. They don't give a fuck about us. I fucking dare any one of these motherfuckers to try to have a face-to-face talk with me. Have a face-to-face talk with me, because I will call you on your bullshit in a fucking heartbeat. Right to your fucking face. All right, Pritzker wants to talk about, oh, we need to have the fair tax thing. You guys need to vote that in so they can change the flat tax rate. When you guys change that flat tax rate so he can tax the rich more, guess what? That thing was legally put into law to protect us Americans from Democrats like him, because as soon as you guys vote for that, and now he has total control of our tax system, he will tax us and take it out of our checks as fast as he fucking wants to. And what he's trying to do to prevent us from doing anything about it is he's trying to fine people when they try to move out of state and sell their house. Try to sue me, fucking Pritzker. Try to. Because I'm not worried about you myself. Eventually, I will see you face to face. And then let's see if you try to smile and smooze me. It's not going to happen. I will see you face to face. You will be out there campaigning on the ground, out in the world. You will be, hey, vote for me, vote for me. And I will see you there. And you better hope the only thing I have is a fucking bullhorn to stand behind you to call every fucking thing you're saying a fucking lie, you toilet fucking removing motherfucker. You guys are so fucking greedy. So greedy. Get the illegal shit fucking taken care of. You want to call people racist? You're a fucking racist if you're not fucking looking out for Americans, you dumb fucking smucks. Because Trump's calling Elijah Cummings fucking Baltimore a fucking piece of shit place. Oh, he's racist. No, it's a fucking fact. Why don't you talk to the people of Baltimore before you start fucking running your fucking mouth, not knowing what the fuck you're talking about, putting your 2 cents in where it's not fucking needed. Look that shit up. People of Baltimore are thanking President Trump for bringing this shit to light. That Cummings has been fucking not doing shit for them all these years. Where's all these billions of dollars he has? Can't ask that because that's racist. You guys are fucking stupid. Man, get your fucking shit right. It's Trump 2020 for me all day. And as far as I'm concerned right now with everything I've been seeing, they haven't done nothing the whole time he's been president except fight him tooth and fucking nail and everything. But then beg him, oh, do this for us, do this for us, do this for us. And they don't do a fucking thing. Get them the fuck out of office. Pelosi needs to sit her old fucking retarded ass down. All right? Get your old cross-eyed ass, sit the fuck down somewhere, and fucking retire. And Schumer, he just looks like a fucking pedophile all day long. You guys need to get these motherfuckers out of office. All right? I'm voting Republican all day long. Every fucking Republican on the ticket is getting that check mark from me. Every fucking one. You Republicans, stop talking about fucking abortion rights and shit like that. You let a woman do what she needs to do with her body. Period. Let her do what she's doing with her body, because that's her fucking business, and it's between her and God. All right? It's none of your business. Who the fuck are you? J.B. Pritzker's fat ass. He made it law where a woman can have an abortion up to the day of her fucking delivery. Think about that. Democrats are looking out for us. Really? You're looking out for us by making it legal to fucking murder a baby up to the day that the baby's going to be born. But they're looking out for us. Right. Right. You better think about that shit. Look where your money's going. Look at your shit, man. Research your shit. If you don't, get on whatever you need to look at. Look up the fucking Judicial Watch up in Washington, D.C. Look them up. Because they're the medium between everybody. They don't have a side. And they're going to show you exactly what the fuck you're not seeing. Because if you people think of the Democrats are all that in a bag of chips, obviously you're only seeing what they want you to see and you're not seeing the whole fucking picture. Take the blinders off your fucking eyes and look at everything and you'll see that they've been playing smoke and mirrors with you for fucking years. And they're still doing it. Look how shitty fucking Illinois is now. Look how shitty it is out here. Look how, in California, you just made it, you want to give fucking illegals free health care? Where's that money coming from? Where the fuck are you getting the fucking money to pay for illegals to have free health care and fucking and public aid and shit? Where are you getting that money from? You're getting it from the taxpayers. From people who have fucking jobs and they're already paying taxes out of their fucking pocket for shit. You're taking that shit and you're giving it, you just giving it to people? Man, and you guys are fucking allowing this. Here's how it gets like this. You people that fucking spank your kids as fucking children. Alright, you didn't tell your kids no. So your kids never learned the fucking meaning of the word no. So now, nowadays they just cry about fucking everything. Get the fuck over it, man. Get the fuck over it. Let's see how this works out, motherfucker. Any one of you fucking Democrats want to fucking come have a conversation with me? I fucking dare you. And I hope you fucking do. Because I'll make you look like the stupid fucking thief that you fucking are. Fucking hit me up on this, man. I hope you fucking guys fucking look this up. I hope you appreciate the fucking facts. And if you're, I apologize for my cussing right away, but if you disagree with me, you can disagree with me. That's your opinion, but keep it to your fucking self, because that just tells me that you ain't fucking informed. You're not informed. I look at both sides. I watch CNN, I watch NBC, I watch ABC, I watch CBS, and I watch Fox. Alright, so I see the bullshit that are coming on the ones, and when you're getting the whole picture. Watch it, man. Fucking, you guys need to just open your fucking eyes. Peace out. I appreciate you guys' love and the Xbox brick. You guys need help. You need to learn something, man. If it's fucking painting, I'm getting ready to, I think I'm going to go hang some drywall today. I got some tile work I'm going to be doing later this week. You guys need help with anything, changing outlets, whatever the fuck it is. Hanging a ceiling fan, man, I'll do a video. I don't give a fuck. I got nothing else to do while I'm at work. I'm working by myself most of the time. Like 90% of the time at work, there's like a crew of six of us on my crew. And 90-95% of the time, I'm working by myself. Even if we're all in the same apartment complex or job site at a new house construction or whatever, 9 times out of 10, I'm still working by myself because as far as they're concerned, I'm a fucking dick and I'm an asshole. So they don't like working with me. I really don't give a fuck. I'm not there to make friends. I'm there to make my check, all right? And if I see you just standing there and you're on your phone the whole fucking time, or you're over here bullshitting, having fucking 3 or 4 fucking cigarette breaks in fucking 20 minutes, yeah, I'm going to fucking say something. I'm going to be a fucking dick about it. I don't give a fuck. It is what it is. You know what I mean? I'm not somebody to hide the truth. I'm not somebody that's going to bite my lip or hold my tongue on shit that's fucking true. If I think you need to fucking hear it, I'm going to fucking let you hear it. All right? Fucking facts hurt? Well, that just means you're fucking doing shit wrong. It's as simple as that. Man, peace out. I love you guys in America. Democrats, you can fucking kiss my fucking ass. Trump 2020, brother. Hey, guys, I just want to throw one more thing out there to you real quick. Just, you know, I'm not racist. I just don't like my money being given to somebody else. All right? But let me just show you something real quick. As I was looking for other little parts of my clip to put in here for this video, I come across something that, luckily, thank God, like a couple months ago, I got me a high-grade security system. And I catch a couple Mexicans trying to break in my car at like 3:30 in the morning. They're trying to break in my woman's car, my work van, and my regular truck. Two Mexican dudes that think I don't know where they live with their four-door Ford F-150 that they keep parked on the other side of their house in the bushes. I want you to see what our Democrats are supporting, okay? So this next little video, that's these motherfuckers trying to break in my vehicle. Pay attention through the whole thing, and you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. And this is just some bullshit that we just need to be dealing with all the day. Should I call the cops on them? Should I have somebody go over there and just crack their fucking skull? Should I go over there and just break in their vehicle? No, I wouldn't do that because I'm not a fucking thief. I fucking can't stand that shit. So let's just get right to this, and you guys can tell me what you think.